Good evening, everyone. Good evening. It's good to see you all as we begin this celebration of the Holy Triduum. Just a couple of notes here before we begin. When we get to the time of our foot washing there, our six little ones there know exactly when they're supposed to come up. I'll invite you up so you don't have no guesses. And at the very end, we're going to have you try to carry the chairs back in, but you might, if you need help, we've got some helpers up here if you're a little on the smaller side, so you don't have to worry about that either. But just a little quick note there before we begin, and then at the very end, we'll be processing for Holy Thursday, simply just up the main aisle, up the back, you know, with our masks on as usual to kind of, again, still have all the pieces of Holy Thursday, but just do it safely as we can. After Mass, everybody, we leave in silence. There is no formal end to Mass because really over the next 3 days, all three of these merge together, our Holy Thursday, Good Friday, into the Easter Vigil. So at the very end, myself, the deacons, and the servers will process out the side, and then everybody is invited to leave in silence, although you will be able to pray with the Blessed Sacrament in the tabernacle all the way until 10 o'clock. At that point this evening, we will do night prayer here within the church, and you're certainly invited to that, but that is at 10 p.m. this evening, after which everything will close up for the evening in terms of formal events. Tomorrow we'll have at 3 p.m. the Stations of the Cross, and then we'll move into, again, our Good Friday service with the, at 7 p.m. for those who have registered for it. If not, then we will also have everything live streamed as well. All right, everybody, thank you very much, and we'll start Mass in just a few moments.
Please stand for our opening hymn.
Good evening, everyone. We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, as we begin the most sacred Triduum, with this the celebration of the Lord's Supper, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal a contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And on earth peace to people of good will.
Let us pray. O God, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the Church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love, grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old, male, and without blemish. You shall take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night, they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loin skirt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand, you shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night, I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt, I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Salvation I will take up, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. A blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ, precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death. Servant, the son of your handmaid, you have loosed my bonds. Our blessed cup is a communion with the blood of Christ. To you will I offer sacrifice of thanksgiving. I will call upon the name of the Lord. My vows to the Lord I will pay in the presence of all his people. Our blessing cup is a communion with the blood of
a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way also the cup, after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant of my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing, you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do." Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The following is a true story that happened only in recent days, and I share it with you tonight for a purpose that I'll get to in a minute. There was a priest in a situation where he had to go into an operating room where somebody was pretty close to the edge of death. As he entered, there was a lot going on with everything in the room, because obviously when somebody's having a cardiac event, things are getting a little crazy as these things go. As this is going on, as he's entering into the room, he hears the doctor saying, "Are we going to call it? Are we going to call it?" Basically saying at this point, there's nothing more we can do for this man. My priest friend, who is the one who is involved in this, kept pressing forward anyway and saying, "You haven't called it yet, so it's time to give the sacrament of anointing." And as he said the words of anointing, which go as follows, "Through this holy anointing, may the Lord in his love and mercy help you with the grace of the Holy Spirit. May the Lord, who frees you from sin, save you and raise you up." As he finished that piece of "save you and raise you up," he popped up. Came back. All the monitors lit up like Christmas, and suddenly he's going again, and they're all looking over like, "Did you?" So he leaves the room after that, because things have returned back to normal. And a little later on, one of the nurses comes out and says, "How did you do that?" And my priest friend simply put it this way. He held up a pencil and he said, "You see this?" And the nurse said, "Yeah." He said, "You don't give, again, the pencil credit for a symphony composed or a beautiful picture drawn or anything of that nature. You give ultimately the artist the credit, right? I'm just the pencil. There's someone else behind all of the symphony, if you will." It's a great illustration of what a gift the priesthood is. And it's something that, again, every priest can probably tell you 1,000 little stories like that, maybe not on that level, so to speak, but 1,000 little stories of God just working in a moment and you being this unworthy instrument in his hands to bring about a great gift. Because part of what we celebrate tonight is the institution of the Holy Priesthood. 2 sacraments are instituted tonight, and that's the first one. That the 12 ultimately become the first bishops, if you will, the cardinals of the church, and if we want to really kind of put all the pieces together, because they're given this fullness of grace of order to act as Jesus will act during the course of his lifetime and make that gift to themselves in a particular way. But there's a second piece also instituted too on this night, and it's the gift we receive from the altar. It's the gift of Jesus Christ himself that the priest, unworthy as he is, but still given this great gift at ordination that conforms his very being to that of Christ in a unique way, can stand up here, say the words of consecration that we've heard so many times before, take this all of you and eat it, take this all of you and drink from it, and all that follows behind it. And what happens is when we hear that simple bell ring from one of the servers, a great gift is given. That's the gift of Jesus Christ himself that is now available to be received into our souls. In essence, this night is being represented to us that we can enter into it every time we come to celebrate a Mass. Now, did you know that? Did you know that that was the gift you're entering into every time you walk through these doors on a Sunday or even a daily Mass? Because that's what we get to participate in. It's nothing short of a miracle. And it is a true gift to understand that God loves us so much that he's going to allow these unworthy instruments to be these gifts, to be able to provide all of these pieces. But with that also comes, as you can probably guess, somebody who wants to thwart that. Because if God is acting decisively in a way to bring about the gifts to his people, who do you think is acting in a way to make sure that gift is thwarted? And sadly, over the years, we've come to know all too well the human frailty that exists, not just in men in general, but again, especially in priests. There's been a lot of damage because of that, because again, we've all been given this gift of free will. Priests are called to make this gift of self, as Christ makes a gift of himself on the cross. That gift of pouring oneself out is not something that can be done in a vacuum. It has to come from the source that is our Lord and Savior. That's why it is so important that a priest receive that gift in and through the gift of the Holy Eucharist, but also in and through the gift of prayer. Because without those things, without that fuel that is the Christian life, it's only a matter of time before that weakness starts to eat away at him and the enemy starts to get the upper hand. It's one of the reasons why, again, we're always grateful when when somebody says to me, "Hey, Father, I'm saying a prayer for you." I go, "Well, thank you. Send them along. Lord knows," because we all need them. Just as, you know, we're saying we're praying for you in those difficult moments and those trying moments, Lord knows we need those prayers too to be able to sustain in our ministry. Because it's out of the abundant grace of God poured into our hearts that we can make that self-gift. And Jesus illustrates it once more tonight when he shows that he is again the servant of servants, if you will. Because what he does for the 12 is show them that you will give as I give. And you will lower yourself to the lowest place. Because then he proceeds to wash their feet. To wash the feet of those who would follow after him and say, "You now must do this for others. As I've made a gift of myself, so you are to make a gift of yourself." And in that we see the heart of the Christian life, which cannot be done outside of the gifts that our Lord provides and in through his sacraments and in and through the gift of prayer, because that's what's going to give us what we need to do what he's asking us towards. And that's not just priests either in that one. That's all of us. So my friends, as we enter into this gift of the Holy Triduum tonight, we understand that gift of service in the sense that Christ makes the ultimate gift of service. He gives everything. And in such, we are called to do no less. Whether it be the priest, whether it be the youngest or oldest among us, does not matter. All of us are meant to make the gift of self. And out of that, our Lord does great things within the midst of our world. This time I'm going to invite our 6 youngest who are going to help us out here to come forward and sit in one of the chairs up here as we prepare for the rite of the washing of the feet.
towel.
You all set with the towel.
Please stand. Confident in our Lord and Savior, as we celebrate this gift of Holy Thursday and the gift that he makes on the cross, let us bring our prayers before him this day, asking for his grace, his mercy, and his peace.
For all Christian disciples, may we serve as agents of change and transformation in a polarized world. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For church leaders, especially the clergy, may tonight's feast of the Lord's Supper spark renewed love for the Eucharist and love for those most in need of inclusion at the Lord's table. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For civic leaders, may they listen to and honor the needs of the people they serve, lowering themselves as Christ did in service to others. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the sick, the lonely, and the lost, may they feast on justice, receiving healing, be surrounded by a supportive and loving community. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And for our mission parish in Haiti, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. All first responders, military, frontline medical people, and support staff, that they all be kept safe and free from harm. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those friends and loved ones who have gone before us into the embrace of our Lord's arms, and tonight especially, we hold up in prayer our parish family, whom we will remember in this liturgy. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all the intentions of our parish prayer chain, and for all those prayers you hold in your hearts that are known to God alone, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Father in heaven, we ask your abundant blessing to be poured upon us this evening as we celebrate this Mass of the Lord's Supper, that through the gift of the Holy Eucharist which Christ bestowed upon us this night, we may grow in your love, grace, and mercy in all things and serve you in our lives as you desire. And we ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I see.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest, who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice, and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in the hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day on which our Lord Jesus Christ was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ. And blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogenus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer for our salvation and the salvation of all, that is today, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, as Almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who, through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen, amen, amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit. Let us now offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We now pray the prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
His voice to me is calling.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
I invite you to kneel now, if you're able, for the transfer of the Blessed Sacrament.